a Nigerian man has openly accused his wife of getting pregnant without his consent, saying that what she did was wrong and that he wasn't going to accept this pregnancy. So we're asking, should this be an issue, especially since there is no doubt that he's the father of the child?
That's not our agreement.
Please.
Which one is Which one is agreement? Which one come off all the money? They don't count children for the owner of children. And your thing cannot multiply for you to be angry. Me now, that's the face I have now. If I don't have permission. But if it happens, nobody should just question me. Because I'm really thinking of ways to cut corners.
You're not, it's not that she's cheating. You know, it's a different thing if you if you think she might be cheating, but you genuinely you know she got pregnant. So, what is the story? What should, what could have been done?
For me, it's a major issue. Because I believe that families should plan. You should have a roadmap to where you're going to. And if you have come to an agreement as a couple that we are done, we're not having any more, it will be unfair on the other partner to get pregnant. Now, I know that people will blame, are you not the one that put it there? But you could have been putting it there and she's been finding a way to, because it's an agreement. So you could have said, okay, let's do family planning or let's use the withdrawal. Psychologically, they may not be ready to have that baby at that time. It's something you need to understand.
Is anybody ready to have the baby?
See, let me tell you, if I knew what I know now, to have kids, I would take my time.
So for me, I believe it's a big deal and it's a betrayal of trust.
Ah,
how seriously that I take it.
Oh, my heart.
Can I have a hat for
you? And it's both ways, because I know of women who have been made pregnant, even though they had agreed with the man that this is not what I want.
Yeah.
There are women who, because of even health reasons, they've been told not to, but the husband goes ahead to do it. So if it's bad in that case for the woman, it's just as bad if a man says, see, we're not ready
for this.
We have a period of time, I would like to do this and do that, and we should not. Don't go about and deceive the person. I know God takes care of everything.
Yes.
Many people will tell you that when we had this child, all of a sudden, open doors and everything. But we also know that it is hard work that people have put together before that has come
to
fruition.
That opened the door, thank
you. And sometimes it happens coincidentally at when you have your child. My own is, don't be deceitful to that point. Do not.
So, ma'am, what if it isn't a matter of deceit? What if it is
genuine mistake?
Genuinely, she didn't even know. You know, there's some people that... And let me put somebody
story
that we
out
know.
Of your mouth.
Murayo will tell you that she doesn't know when she gets pregnant. Like, she didn't know she was already pregnant.
One, she's,
she had no idea.
At a level that is beyond us.
I'm telling you.
Yes, and he had passed a specific period that everybody would know. So if somebody like that gets pregnant and she didn't even know she was pregnant, she wasn't looking to get pregnant, and then she comes and says, I'm pregnant and we are 4 months now. Okay. It's not deceit.
Okay,
it happened.
Yeah, so that's why I clearly mentioned that there are different situations, scenarios, but we do have a scenario where people have been openly and deliberately deceitful. We have scenarios where both parties are even on board. We're not doing this. So it's not even one party thinking, I want it, but he doesn't, or she wants it, and I don't. The thing is, when it happens mistakenly like that, the conversation will be different. It's not openly coming to accuse. This one is coming, openly
upset,
coming to accuse.
Like, somebody is doing something behind the scene.
Would it be deceit if you don't, want the situation and you take care of yourself because you own your body?
Let me get you this way.
I'm putting a family plan.
So, would it be deceitful if a woman doesn't want to get pregnant and she goes to the family, to the hospital and does personalized family planning without telling her husband?
Yes.
Is deceitful.
Of course. When you go to hospitals to take some serious, to do some very almost permanent procedures, fertility and what do you call it, family planning procedures, they usually ask you
for your spouse,
do the consent with your husband or with your wife.
Okay,
so the man who's going for a vasectomy, they'll fight and you're in a marriage, you will have to.
No, for me, I want us to drive towards a point of that agreement. If there is an agreement, if both of you agree not to have children, then there is no case of I'm accusing you of doing something. Because both of you have gotten on the page.
Both of you agree and the method that you're using
fails.
Because I have agreed, that's my situation. We have two and I want more. And my husband is tired of the whole process of, you know, the things I have to go through when I'm pregnant. So he doesn't want that problem again, and doesn't want that stress put on me. So he's constantly having this conversation. Initially, I agreed. And now I'm, you know, I'm not agreeing so much like that.
Your mind.
So I've changed my mind, you know, slowly, and I can reason with him, but I'm not agreeing.
In the hospital.
The responsibility of making sure that is the case is on both of them. So men would understand that they too can take some family planning decisions as well. As she said, you cannot be firing without protection.
If you
don't want a child, there are things you need to do as the man, not to have children.
There's something I also noticed when it comes to relationship and marriages. When people are getting together and they're discussing the plans they have for the future, sometimes they try to mirror each other. Because I like this person and I see the good qualities in this person, I don't want to lose this person. The man says, I just want two kids. In your heart, you want six. You just say, two is okay. We'll have two. I want two. Just because you want to get into that marriage. Along the line, after you've had that two, your original intention was to have six. Then you start coming in. You start manipulating. You want to start talking about it. Anytime you see a baby, your heart leaps for joy. Oh, baby, I wish I'm the one that's carrying this one. And you've had that two. I think it's unfair and we should stop it. Now, along the line also, you could change your mind, like Nima, along the way. But as you are changing your mind, you try and carry your spouse along in that changing. If they refuse to change, you have already agreed to have to. Please stick to it.